It's almost like you were off to the outer side. The morning sun is on the valley. It's time you were on your way. Time you were learning the pitman's job.
Well, I work as a home carer, and this time last month I was on 22 hours a week. And this week, as I speak, I only have 11 and 12 hours a week. And when I see all the elderly people and the people that are disabled that I have worked with, being so disappointed and practically driven to tears because their home care has been cut from them. And it's just not right.
Okay, well, I'm here today to support the communities against cuts, protests in particular, and to show, and I'm delighted that there's so many people here already as well, showing some solidarity against the cuts that communities have faced in many, many different projects over the last 5 years. And we see it in communities and in families, and individuals have lost so many allowances and benefits, and it has to stop. We can't just keep on taking these austerity cuts. For what end? To pay off invisible bondholders and bankers.
Can I welcome you all to this great gathering and day of change? A great day because lots of us who are opposed to austerity in our different ways have united and come together to stand together.
Communities are losing projects which were established as part of an infrastructure which took 30 years to build. An infrastructure that was based on the needs of those communities. In just 3 years, this infrastructure has been dismantled by senior officials in government departments and the government.
And the very first thing you do is you make sure you're in a trade union. Are you all in unions? Then the next thing you do is you go back to your workplace, if you're fortunate enough to have a job, and you talk to your comrades and colleagues in your workplaces, and you persuade them in their best interest that they need to take industrial action to defend you, them and their class in this country. That should be easy. And when you do that, you then take that motion to your executive council of your union, and you persuade them to pass a motion in favour of doing that. That's easy. Do it. And when you do that, you get your union to bring that forward to the Congress of Trade Unions. And it's an irresistible force that Congress will welcome.
I'm here to protest against the potential cuts now in the budget coming up in January. And I think it's time that the government stood up for the people as opposed to paying fucking the IMF. And, you know, burn the bondholders. Why any investor should be, basically, if you invest in anything and it's a bad investment, you should pay the penalty. Why should, you know, anyone else get away with it, like the bondholders? You know, the Irish people are getting crucified here between cuts, and austerity is not working. Anybody knows, if you want to generate an economy, you put money back into it. And that's where I feel about it now. And if you don't get out, Irish people need to get up off their arse and do something about it.